लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल गुरमीत सिंह जी, चीफ मिनिस्टर श्री पुष्कर सिंह धामी जी, जनरल ऑफिसर कमांडिंग इन चीफ आर्मी ट्रेनिंग कमांड लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल राज शुक्ला जी, इस्टीम्ड गेस्ट्स फ्रॉम फ्रेंडली फॉरेन कंट्रीज, प्राउड पेरेंट्स एंड जेंटलमैन कैडेट्स ऑफ द पासिंग आउट कोर्स, वी गेदर हियर टुडे when the nation is yet to come out of the shock of the untimely demise of General Bipin Rawat, the Chief of Defence Staff. As you know, 12 others, including General Rawat's wife, Srimati Madhulika Rawat ji, were also killed in the chopper crash. General Rawat was an extraordinary military leader, and his death creates a void that cannot be filled. Uttarakhand was his home, and he was trained at the Indian Military Academy. Here, he was awarded the Sword of Honor for his exceptional skills. But for the tragedy, he would have been among us here today, looking at the passing out parade with delight and pride for the cadets. General Rawat added to the glory of the IMA, which is an institution with an inspiring tradition. Before him, Field Marshal K.M. Kariappa, Field Marshal Sam Manekshaw, and many other extraordinary warriors and strategists began their journey here as young cadets and potential leaders. Some of them laid down their lives for the safety and honor of our nation. The IMA is acclaimed worldwide for its nearly 9 decades of history and heritage. Its buildings and sprawling campus are impressive indeed. It gives me pleasure to see before me the batch of 387 gentlemen cadets who would shortly embark on their journey of a life characterized by valor and wisdom. I am sure they will carry forward the rich legacy of this academy. I appreciate the immaculate turnout and an impressive display of drill. This parade comprises cadets from all parts of India and from diverse communities, as also from 10 friendly foreign countries. This is indeed a true manifestation of our unity, as also of our plural society. Gentlemen cadets, your training here equips you to face the challenges that await you. As commissioned officers, you will be expected to blend knowledge, skills, and professional application. You must internalize the Chatwood motto inscribed in your academy. All of you know the motto very well. Yet, I find it so good that I would like to repeat it for the benefit of all the cadets passing out today. The motto reads, and I quote, "The safety, honor, and welfare of your country come first, always and every time. The honor, welfare, and comfort of the men you command come next. Your own ease, comfort, and safety come last, always and every time." Gentlemen cadets, you will have the authority to lead men into battle. At the same time, you will also be expected to uphold the admiration and trust that your uniform evokes amongst fellow countrymen. You must always remain mindful that your actions will influence the outcome of military operations. Your decisions will have an impact on the lives of men under your command, and your dedication to services will have a multifaceted impact on our country. The challenges that our great nation faces today are defined by a complex security environment at the regional and global level. You must, therefore, keep in mind that physical and mental toughness alone will not equip you to tackle modern-day threats to the country. As military leaders, you will have to develop a strategic mindset, cultivate an adaptive temperament and acquire the mental resilience essential to hone the skills required for military leadership. You must be prepared to deal with the unexpected challenges that the profession of arms shall present before you at various junctures of your service. Gentlemen cadets, advancement in technology has often been driven by military dynamics. The battlefield today presents multidimensional situations. Armed forces across the world are heavily reliant on use of technology to deter or defeat the enemy's fighting capability. As modern-day military leaders, you must embrace this technological shift and understand the seamless synergy required between men and machines. It is therefore imperative that you develop sound scientific temperament and include the desire and passion to adopt technology and innovation. I feel happy to see the gentlemen cadets from friendly foreign countries of Afghanistan, Bhutan, Maldives, Myanmar, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Tajikistan, Tanzania, Turkmenistan, and Vietnam here today. We cherish the special bond between our nations, and it is a matter of great pride for India to have such fine officers and gentlemen from friendly foreign countries graduating today. I am sure that you will preserve the unique bond of friendship forged with your colleagues and instructors during your training here at the IMA. Gentlemen cadets, I once again congratulate you on the successful completion of your training at the IMA and wish you a very bright future marked by success and glory. Your service and dedication as soldiers and leaders of men shall add to the strength of a peaceful, independent, and democratic India. On this occasion, let us recall the iconic status acquired by one of the many illustrious alumni of the Academy, General Bipin Rawat, who by dint of his hard work emerged as the role model of solidarity, conduct for the future generation. Our flag shall always fly high because brave men like you will preserve and protect its honor. I also extend my heartiest congratulations to the proud families of the cadets passing out today. Thank you. Jai Hind.